It appears that if you want to find out the motivation behind anything these days, then all you've got to do is follow the money. If there's any area in society where cash can be made from exploiting the gullible, then you can safely bet there'll be someone somewhere raking it in. And nowhere is this more evident than in the world of ghost hunting. With currently approximately 2/5 of the US population and 1/3 of the UK population believing that ghosts and the afterlife do exist and are real, which is nearly 156 million people, is there any wonder that ghost hunting is currently big business? Locations throughout the world have carefully and methodically built up a reputation on the notion that they are indeed haunted. It seems you can't go anywhere now without there being some reliable eyewitness testimony about a floating full-body apparition of a lady in white, red, brown, or whatever colour clothing they've decided to throw on for a night of being mysterious, hanging around spooky places, and scaring the shit out of anyone they happen across. So there's absolutely no surprise at all that said alleged haunted locations have seized upon the opportunity and decided to cash in. With that in mind, and as a totally free public service announcement to all would-be intrepid ghost hunters, I'm Rich from Paranormal Tedium, and here are our bottom 5 allegedly haunted locations in the UK that you must pay to investigate. Number 5. Before we get into it, if you're new here, please consider subscribing to the channel and clicking that little bell icon. We're trying out new content all the time, so we'd hate for you to miss out. Okay, here we go. Number 5. Ooh, remember to give this vid a thumbs up too. Not only will it make you instantly feel better about yourself, you'll be helping us out a little in the process. Thanks. Oh, and one more thing. Before anyone goes ranting in the comments,
nah, you're just ripping off other popularist channels in a desperate attempt to gain more views, likes and subscriptions.
Well, let me just point out that this is a parody and ultimately a homage to these channels. So twat and get over yourself, okay? Let's continue. But yeah, you're right. We are. Look, just forget about that and let's bloody well get on with the list, shall we? Jeez. Number 5. 30 East Drive, Pontefract, West Yorkshire, England. Starting somewhat close to home, 30 East Drive and the twatting black monk of Pontefract are probably the most notorious of UK institutions within the paranormal community, irrespective of where you live on the planet. You've only got to search on YouTube to be instantly inundated with a multitude of video content, all claiming to show evidence of some kind or another of paranormal activity at that former council house property. It seems that every intrepid ghost hunter and their grandmothers have been there to investigate at some point. I mean, seriously people, it's been bloody well done to death. Ha! Did you see what I did there? Even the current owner and 30 East Drive filmmaker Bill Bungay claims on the website he hasn't actually stayed overnight, and states you'd be nuts to want to. Although the location has been debunked to buggery in recent years, that doesn't stop intrepid ghost hunters going there, eager to see if they can catch a glimpse of the mischievous black monk, also known as Mr. Nobody, also known as Fred. So what will it set you back financially to investigate this most infamous Yorkshire alleged haunt? For groups of 1 to 4 people, you'll need to fork out £300 a night to stay between Monday and Thursday. Seriously? That's 75 quid per person per night. You can get a room at the Grand Hotel in Scarborough for less than that. And that includes an evening meal and breakfast. 30 East Drive, Grand Hotel. 30 East Drive, Grand Hotel. I know where I'd rather be staying for the money. Should you want to stay a night between Friday and Sunday, or on a public holiday, then the cost jumps to £400 a night. The cost per head does drop though, for groups of 5 and up, to a maximum of 10 people, as the cost per night is exactly the same as it is for groups of 1 to 4. But this is only available to professional or specialist groups that have obtained liability insurance beforehand. Then on top of that, get this, you've got to take your own twatting bed in.
The fuck?
On the upside, if you can call it a chuffing upside, there's only one double bed, one single bed, and one small single bed, so you won't have to take that much bedding with you. Although, I'm not quite sure where the rest will sleep. On the floor most probably. There is a 10% discount available, however, for 5 or more bookings. But
here we fucking go.
The caveat to that is that consecutive nights are classed as one continual booking. Once everyone's signed the visitor waiver, in blood, I shouldn't imagine, then you're good to go. Should you require a protection spell to safeguard your stay, then these can be arranged at £10 per person by a local medium.
Twatting heard it all now, for fuck's sake.
Having said all that, there is some good news for a specific demographic of the populace. Should you be a theoretical physicist and wish to visit 30 East Drive, then you can gladly stay for free. Number 4. Inveraray Jail, Inverarary, Argyll, Scotland. Across the border we go now to the land of Celts, Clans and Cabotossin.
Oh, young man!
Inveraray Jail appears to be another quite popular location, for as the website states, the jail has a reputation as one of Scotland's most haunted... Ooh, just those two words together gives me the shits. Okay, moving on. One of Scotland's most haunted locations. Because I can imagine that stating a location as being the least haunted place around isn't going to be a huge tourist pull. Especially with the members of the paranormal cult, I mean, community. Although a blog on said website called Is Inveraray Jail Haunted falls short of explicitly claiming that it is, intrepid ghost hunters a go-go flock there to capture whatever compelling evidence they can. There have also been ghost hunting events open to the public, which are organised by Ghost Events Scotland and the Scottish Paranormal Team. These events cost £45 per person and go on from 8pm to 2am. The Ghost Events Scotland website states that they welcome you to bring your own equipment, and whether an enthusiasm...
Fucking enthusiasm!
A newbie or paranormal investigation team, feel free within reason to...
Oh, this just gets twatting better.
Get this. Bring some data. Yes, that's bring some data to gather tools with you.
It's like the fucking incompetent copywriter.
So if you want to bail out, I just can't help myself, can I? Of said organised events by said organisers whose literacy doesn't exactly fill me with confidence, then what's the outlay to be able to perform a private investigation at Inveraray Jail? For groups of up to 10 people, it's a steal at just £350 to hire the location, but for only 5 hours this time, between 8pm and 1am. For groups of 11 people and over, up to a maximum of 30, the cost increases to £500 for the same 5 hours. Either way, you're still going to need to have liability insurance. So, the trade-off here seems to be to go for fewer people to reduce contamination of any compelling evidence you're trying to gather, or go with a larger group to reduce the cost down to a minimum of just under £17 per person. There are 3 separate buildings on the site to investigate though: the courtroom, the old prison, and the new prison. There's also access to toilets and a room to act as a base, so splitting down into smaller groups and rotating these groups through each building would reduce some of the potential cross-group contamination. Number 3. The Tivoli Venue, Buckley, Flintshire, Wales. Ah, the Tiv. I've only been there once myself, and that was back in the early 90s for a rock night they used to host regularly. I looked completely different back then, and have fond memories of that night. Great music, great people, but mainly getting lost on the drive over from Sheffield, as neither my mate or I had any fucking clue exactly where the place was. We did eventually find it after asking a few people along the way, and it was a fantastic night. Little did I know at the time, but the Tivoli has been the site of some unusual activity since the original building was constructed back in 1880. And I'm not just referring to what we got up to in the ladies' toilets. Nudge, nudge, wink, wink.
Say no more, know what I mean, nudge, nudge.
Because nothing happened. Damn it. The website mentions that there are numerous tales of friendly and sometimes malevolent ghosts and spirits who reside in and walk through the building. These tales are from staff, both past and present, and from visiting mediums and intrepid ghost hunters alike. It also mentions that a high level of paranormal activity has been recorded there, so much so that the venue has been the focus of many a TV and radio show, and has been featured on and investigated by Most Haunted.
Well, that's fucking clinched it for me. It's gotta be twatting haunted. Why would anyone else bother to go and investigate?
If you are still curious and wish to experience the place for yourself, then the venue does put on events occasionally, which they call Tivoli Hauntings. These events typically cost around the £25 to £30 mark per person, and, as per our last entry, also run from 8pm to 1am. The cost does include a hot drink, a snack, tour of the building, and also provides group and lone vigils. But what if you wanted to go without all the extraneous bodies, potentially clouding and contaminating all the compelling evidence you're bound to capture? For that privilege, you'll need to stump up £495 and have liability insurance. For my money, I'd rather go and see some of the live bands that frequent the venue. Acts like Dora Pesh, Hardline, Tiger Tales, Bullet Boys and LA Guns, to name a few, have all played there in recent years. So get your eyeliner out, top up your nail polish and go rock out. Ladies, that includes you too. Number 2, Chillingham Castle, Alnwick, Northumberland, England. Now this is more like it. A location for a better class of investigator. Chillingham Castle, according to the website's footer, is a 13th century Grade 1 star-listed stronghold in the county of Northumberland, northwest England, and is famed for action and battles. With its fine rooms, gardens, lakes, fountains and tea rooms, the castle professes an extraordinary ownership bloodline which runs back to the 1200s. As you'd expect from a location as old as this, the suggestion that the place is indeed haunted is an absolute given. In fact, the website boasts some of the highest levels of paranormal activity in the country have been recorded there, and goes on to say that a large collection of spectres and apparitions have been spotted by visitors over the years. You can sample the wealth of alleged ghostly goings-on by attending one of their many two-hour ghost tours that occur frequently throughout the year. These cost £25 per person for anyone aged 16 and 17, and leaps to a lordly £50 per person for the 18 and overs. Should you wish to get a little more hands-on, then look out for their occasional 4-hour guided group ghost hunts, which are also at the cost of £50 per person. There are also ghost hunt workshops available, where experienced ghost hunter Richard will give a masterclass on how to use ghost hunting equipment and teach the different techniques. Will he? Will he now? At twatting £25 per person for just 2 hours of bullshit, tuition, I'm sure he bloody well will. That's all well and good for the uninitiated layperson to get a feel for it all. But what about your intrepid ghost hunting team who already have all the gadgets, are armed with all they wish to know about the paranormal and just want to get in there and investigate? Well, for groups of up to 20 people, you'll need to raid the coffers for the princely amount of £1,200. That's at the very minimum £60 per person for just 4 hours of buggering about in the dark. For that price, I think I'd rather head back to the Tiv for a rock night and see what I could get up to in the dark there. Ladies? Moving on. Groups of up to 25 can attend, with the extra 5 people only being charged £50 per person. So, if you are going in a group of over 20 people, then I suggest you make sure you're one of these 5. During your 4-hour time slot, you'll get access to the Great Hall, the Minstrels Hall, the Edward I Room, the Torture Chamber and the Dungeon, all the while you'll be presided over by their experienced guide.
It isn't Richard by any chance, is it?
Should you wish to sleep over after your 4 hours of intensive investigation, then you're granted a whopping 5%. Yes, that's a whole twatting 5% off accommodation costs.
Oh, the generosity is over-fucking-whelming.
When you consider how much it physically costs to book a stay, ranging from £110 per night for the guardroom apartments, all the way up to £310 per night for the grey apartment, I suppose the cash saved is not, as they say, to be sniffed at.
Who? Who twatting says that?
On top of that, the cost per night does drop if you stay for longer, but it still adds up. Finally, should you wish to dine for an evening repast, then something can most definitely be arranged for the merest £35 per person. Having just splashed out £1,200 to investigate the bloody place, if it wasn't at least 3 courses and served by trained silverback gorillas in full tuxedos, then I'd be sorely disappointed. Number 1. Jamaica Inn, Belventer, Cornwall, England. The legendary Jamaica Inn. I've passed it more than a few times on the way to Cornish family holidays back in the late 70s, early 80s, and a few trips to Newquay in the early 90s camping with the lads, but I've never actually been into the inn. So what hasn't been said about the place that the likes of Daphne du Maurier and filmmaker Alfred Hitchcock, along with all the other stories told about the inn, haven't already stated? Well, it's commonly thought that Jamaica Inn was so named because it was used to store rums smuggled into the country from Jamaica. However, according to the website, the name is said to derive from the important local landowning Trelawney family, of which 2 of whose members served as governors of Jamaica in the 18th century. The inn itself was built in 1750, with the coaching house, stables and tack room being added on some 28 years later in 1778. Due to the inn's isolated location between Bodmin and Launceston, within the boundaries of the infamous Bodmin Moor, contraband smuggled into the country was often stored there on its way through to Devon and beyond. It's estimated that half of the brandy and a quarter of all tea that was illicitly brought into the country landed on the shores of Cornwall and Devon. So you can imagine exactly how much contraband passed through the coaching inn. With all this skullduggery going on, plus the addition of the odd alcoholic beverage or two, you can bet that altercations occurred, resulting in the untimely demise of smugglers, staff and patrons. So the place being haunted should go without saying, right? Well, according to the website, the British Paranormal Association have made in-depth investigations, compiled a report based on their findings and awarded the inn an official stamp of approval for being a genuine haunted establishment.
Fuckers.
Unfortunately, or conveniently, whichever way you want to look at it, I struggle to find any real presence of this association online. All that can be found is a failed crowdfunder page, an entry page on Yell.com that has a broken website link, and a link to a different web address associated with this organisation, which was blocked by my browser and my antivirus because it was a known threat.
A threat to fucking sanity and all that sensible no twatting doubt.
Thus, we could not get a hold of said report to validate.
Which fucking figures.
So, who else has been there to attest to the inn's genuine haunted establishment status?
Oh, I should have fucking known. Twatting most haunted.
But if you don't want to take either group's word for the alleged hauntedness...
Hauntedness? Is that an actual word? I'm just going to run with it.
But if you don't want to take either group's word for the alleged hauntedness of the inn, then you're more than welcome to go find out for yourself. For groups of up to 19 people, you're going to have to spring a piratical £1,520 for the night, which is at best £80 per person, and at worst, enough to make even Jack Sparrow twatting blush. And once again, yes, you guessed it, you must have the old liability insurance. What you're getting for this sum, though, is the hire of the entire old block, which, I was reliably informed, is the only way to keep the public away from investigations as much as possible, till the bars close later that night, of course. And, as the inn is a busy working hotel, a sleepover is the only way to accommodate any intrepid ghost hunters. The old block consists of the apparently famous and allegedly haunted bedrooms 3 through 6, in addition to the actually non-famous, most definitely non-haunted bedrooms 7 through 12, all of which, by the way, are your sleeping quarters for the night. I imagine the cost also pays for the wages for the two inn team members who chaperone your activities, but who, as I've also been informed, do try to stay out of the way as much as possible. If you're only a small group of intrepid ghost hunters and the cost is way out of your budget, don't worry, you can opt to arrange a team share event to spread out the cost with another group or groups. And that's the end of this bottom five list.
No, really, Rich. We thought you were going to go through zero and start into imaginary numbers, you dickhead.
Yeah, I know, it is a stupid thing to say, but that's how they all seem to end these kind of countdown list vid thingies. I just hope you liked it. If you know of any other alleged haunted locations anywhere in the world that you have to pay to investigate, then please let us know down in the comments. If you did like the vid, then please give it a thumbs up and we'll consider doing more of this content. As this is our first bottom five list vid, and as an incentive for us to make more, you could suggest topics for potential future bottom five lists. You can do that down in the comments too. Finally, consider subscribing to the channel, remembering to click the bell icon for notifications. You can follow us on Facebook, donate to us on Patreon, and check out our merch storefronts on Spreadshop. Links to all of these are in the vid description. I've been Rich from Paranormal Tedium. Thanks for watching.